time, he'll go down to E minor. And then to A minor. Again, E minor. And make sure you land on the third string there. So it's E minor. Same E minor to A minor, and this time the octaves change. So, E minor, same. So it's I'll actually use my fourth finger there. It's already in place after the octaves, you know. So that's really just bar chord first fret and fourth finger on third fret of the D string. They're all first fret bars, nothing else. Yeah. last time. Just holds it. And then the sort of jazzy section, if you like. First, second, third fingers on the sixth fret, the fifth, fourth, and third strings. And you hit it twice. So, all together. Now, it separates, but of course, your second finger stays on the sixth fret. Your first finger moves down to the fifth fret on the A string. Your third finger moves up to the seventh fret on the D string. So again, we get these. I think it's better probably if you just play the, as the second one, just the fourth and third strings, both times, in fact probably all times. Okay, this one's down to, we've got C and fourth frets on the fourth and third strings, then it slides up, this time again seventh and seventh on the A and G strings, and eighth fret with the third finger on the D string. Again, we've got finger picking on the fourth and third on that second beat. And then we get this one. Now this one is F, third fret on the D string, and then you've got the second fret on the G. With your fourth finger, you're playing the third fret of the B string. But you've got an opening in there as well. So we've gone from here. Last one is like it's like an F bar. You've got first fret, and first fret on the first three strings, and then fourth fret here.